Hello, my name is Ambrose. I've got these golden digger wasps here. And they are big and scary. Although, if you don't bother them, they won't bother you in the form of stinging you. Let's go take a look at them. They're very pretty. Golden digger wasps are predatory, solitary wasps. They have a large body with a pubescence of fine soft hairs. Wasps use vibrational sounding, which is a form of echolocation, to detect what is underneath the sandy soil. When the female taps her antennae on the substrate surface, she receives a returning vibration through organs in her legs. Then she knows what's below the surface. It's pretty amazing. This one's cleaning itself. Look at it go. They're very sanitary, like most insects. When you see their abdomens pulsating or pumping, it means they're breathing. Here is a mating pair on the road. The male has paler wings than the female. The female is turning her head around. She must be looking for danger. Also, she might be holding an insect leg, probably a grasshopper. Here's a male. His eyes are very big. Females do have big eyes as well. On his wing, it's actually lighter than the female's, which is more orangey red, while the male is mostly white. This male seems to be looking for a female to mate with, as it's been flying around very frantically and annoying the females. I've often seen that the males approach the females when they're busy around their nest to mate. The females here are defending themselves or escaping from the males. These females are not interested in mating right now. You're not going to get a mate like that, little dude. Golden digger wasps excavate a main burrow tunnel with branching tunnels and a brood cell. Each brood cell holds between 3 to 7 insects, which the female has paralyzed for her little larvae and carried back to her nest, which is in the sandy soil. Did you just see that? She headbutted an ant. Poor ant. This female has caught some prey and dropped it near the entrance of her burrow. She's paralyzed it, and by the looks of it, it's a grasshopper or a katydid. She's digging the sand from her burrow entrance. The female hunts for insects such as grasshoppers, katydids, and crickets. Seems like she's gone inside to check on her nest. Everything must be okay to her because she's emerged and taking the grasshopper inside. If this is the last prey she'll need to fill her nest, she'll lay an egg on it in her nest. And then she'll come out and backfill her nest with soil and leave, never to return again. Golden digger wasps may create 11 nests in their lifetime before they die, and that's a lot. Once the larvae hatch, they'll eat the paralyzed insects for 1 to 2 weeks. Once the larvae have finished eating, it will cocoon itself. They will pupate, and then later emerge as an adult wasp to repeat the life cycle once again. There are many species of sand wasps in different sizes and colours. There's the black sand-loving wasp. You can see this one digging in the sand. It must be very tiring, because as it digs out the sand, more sand falls in. This is also a solitary hunting wasp. Black sand-loving wasps can sting, but they're not aggressive. Their sting is a modified ovipositor, which injects venom to paralyze but not kill its prey. The adult black sand-loving wasp feeds on nectar and honeydew. It pulls its stinging when a little ant came close. Every now and then, the wasp twirls around when it's digging. Maybe it's tracking for predators, or maybe memorizing its nest, or something else. Another sand wasp is the native Australian Bemix sand wasp. Here they are, digging the sand from the entrance of their nest. They also seem to be building short furrows in the sand, perhaps to confuse the insects which parasitize wasp nests. This one seems to be moving a small pebble from its dig site. It's rather strong. They're such fast diggers and fast flyers. They're so busy. This wasp is covering its nest with sand and a small pebble. I notice that wasps often put small pebbles on their nest entrances. Maybe they use the pebble to hide the entrance and block it off from predators. Or maybe it's just so they can find it, as they usually nest closely with other ones. They eat nectar, which gives them energy from making the nest and hunting flies. They're excellent hunters, and just like dragonflies, they can capture and paralyze their prey on the wing. They also carry their prey back to their nest for their larvae to feed on. They nest as a group, and when they defend their nest, they can sometimes even group up as a swarm to attack the predator. But if you don't bother them, they won't bother you either. I better say goodbye, so thanks for watching and bye for now. This was an amazing sight. And subscribe so you can join me on our next adventure.